If you're wondering how to get an 8.5 piece of paper like this to be a poster size or an anchor chart like this, that's what I'm going to show you guys today.
Today, I'm going to share with you
two ways to achieve your small printout PDF turning into a poster size. All right, let's get started.
All right, the first way I'm going to show you is by using Adobe Acrobat. You're just going to scroll to the page that you want to print. And then when we actually print, we're going to go to poster and make sure you're on just your current page so you don't want to print all of them. I changed my overlap to the 0.05 inches and I've decided to do a 210 scale. Now you'll see me kind of like clicking off, and that's why if you click in between the different ones, it will show you how many pages it takes up and exactly what it looks like. When you have it just like you want it, you're going to press print. Okay, as soon as you print it out, you are going to want to basically trim the edges. So you'll see that I'm careful to try and get as close as I can to the lines and the images. And it's kind of just like a giant puzzle, and you're gonna end up gluing them on top. So try and keep track of which ones you need to cut, which ones you don't, because you wanna have an overlapping edge that you can glue on top of. And so you'll just go through and you'll basically be trimming like one side for each page for it to lay on top and then have that little edge where you can glue. Okay, now option two is to go over to officedepot.com. So you're going to want to go to document printing and you're going to select blueprints. As you can see, blueprints is $3.99 each. Go to customize and then you are going to upload your file. Now, as you can see, these images that I'm using is, it was actually an image. And so I'll put the link below. There's a website that you can use for free that can turn your PDFs into images. Make sure you press fit to paper and then you're ready to check out. Now you can just say that you want to do store or curbside. That's what I normally do to save myself the delivery charge. And I just pop in and pick it up. And here's what it looks like when it's finished. Now I did want to add in that there is one third and final way. So that is that you can take a blank piece of paper or a piece of chart paper and you can put it on your board, you can shine your projector on it, and then you can trace. Now personally, I'm just not a good tracer and I really like things to look crisp, clear, and exactly like they look on the computer. So the first two options are my favorite. But if you need a money time-saving option and you're a great tracer, then the third option is also a great tool that you can use. If you enjoyed this video, I would love if you would take a second and hit the like and subscribe button. And if you want to be notified of future videos like this and other classroom management teacher ideas that I share, make sure you also hit the little bell so that you can be notified when a new video comes out. We'll see you guys next time.